Hey everyone, it's Ryan from GameDevHQ.com. Discord announced a while back the start of something beautiful, and that'd be the Discord store and Nitro games. Both have just been launched out of the beta, and you can experience them directly in your Discord app currently. At this point, however, you might be wondering, why is a game development site covering the scoop on Discord? Well, that's simply because this creates a new platform for indie developers to actually reach an audience with. When it comes to selling your game as an indie developer, previously the only real hot seat was to be on the Steam library. With the introduction to early access availability on the Discord store, there's an opportunity to double up, or perhaps simply the Discord store might just flop. We don't really know just yet, as it just came out, so in this video, we'll be talking about the comparisons that we know from Steam and Discord, and when it comes to buying a game or putting a game out there. Of course, don't forget to subscribe for more game development related content and tutorials. With nothing else to go over, let's jump right into our first issue. First thing we dive right into is simply the cost of selling your project on Discord and Steam. Steam has been getting a lot of flack for their high 30% of all sales from developers. It's caused quite a few to start looking for alternate directions, but they didn't get any impact since there's really no competitors until now. This brings us to our confusion when we discovered that Discord is actually following the exact same path of 30% off sales. You would think that to compete in a new market, you would undercut the price to try to pull developers to use the platform from Steam, but this doesn't seem to be the case. While this may be the stopping point for most developers on which platform to use, we feel that Discord will make a change after the continued backlash in the community, making Discord hopefully the more profitable margin in the future. If not, then Discord might simply never see the outcome they're looking for. We don't know that for sure, however, so don't let that stop you from taking a look at what's going on in the world of Discord further. Steam currently holds the stick for the top user base at 18.5 million users versus Discord's 8.2 million at peak time. While there is a 10 million concurrent user base difference, the platforms are obviously completely different. Steam known for purchasing games, while Discord is known for communicating through those games. The growth rate of Discord, however, is still currently at about 1.5 million users a week, so it's clear people prefer to use Discord over any other voice and chat service. So when it comes to their games, I feel that now the store is open, we'll start getting more people directly interested in Discord simply to see what they have to offer, especially once we start seeing things like Discord exclusives or the Discord first games. Additionally, Nitro Games is another service added to the Discord store. It allows you to pay about 10 bucks a month to get direct access to a library of games, currently at about 60 titles. This is a fantastic service, but I'm curious to see if a new game is added to both locations and everyone is playing it through Discord Nitro and not buying it, how it affects the developer's food on the table. It's more available to me as a gamer to look at the idea of a subscription service for games instead of paying the $20 or more per new title. I imagine it works similar to kind of how Netflix pulls their funds, but even they struggled with this model in the past. Kudos in advance, however, to Discord if they master Nitro Games, because I surely would be signing up to this myself once the library grows, but until we know what developers gain from that, however, maybe it's wise to kind of wait. For ease of use, the Discord launcher has also been released. This lets you pull any game from your computer once added to Discord. This lets you pull up the game regardless of the launcher that it actually was required to run. I feel this will appeal to a lot of people who purchase games outside of Steam, making Discord even more valuable to them as kind of a must-have application regardless of the store's success. As a developer, you can find Discord Developer Portal to add things in your game that directly link to this aspect of Discord, things like party making, sending invites, or you can find similar options kind of in Steam to invite your friends and form a group party. But as it improves, it'll hopefully fix the issues that people have been faced with, things like overlay from the Discord bugging out, or if we compare it to Steam, ensuring a comfortable experience, unlike the big picture mode, which, did I mention, I really hate the big picture mode. If Discord frees me from that quality of life mistake that Steam has made, well then, I'll certainly be developing for Discord myself in the future. With the launch of the store, currently gifting is not available. This is a no-brainer in my opinion, and seeing that it's not readily available on launch makes it kind of seem like the first version of the store. I'm assuming we can expect updates as it goes, but the amount of times that I've gifted my friends a game is uncanny. It makes gaming with your friends just so much easier. If someone tight on money and you just want to get them in the lobby with you as soon as possible, it's just what I would do and how I would handle it. That connection with your friends and family at the click of a button on Steam has pretty much made many good years for me on their platform. And without gifting, I don't see myself personally actually using the store or expecting my friends to try the store or the new streaming service that they're offering. For a platform that grew from communication and connecting, I feel the lack of gifting games is simply a step backwards. As developers, I would want everyone to be able to access title as easy as possible, which makes Steam more applicable. Discord appears to run much smoother than Steam and offers direct news sources from the games that people have been playing. If you view the activity tab in your actual Discord app, you can see all of the games that your friends have been playing, and below it will tag any actual news related to that game. The news can be from the developers directly, or it'll actually source it sometimes from a third-party location or their main website. I feel this really helps push developers to share the news to their players and create kind of a viral engine through the many mechanics that Discord has been using to put that information right in front of their player base. I've never really looked at it until now, really, but the release of the store of those components is really going to be the icing on the cake to this awesome release. To compare it to Steam, there isn't really any news unless the developer uploads it to Steam. However, I could be wrong on that, as it appears that some will actually link to original sources, but it appears more like a blog space whenever I go to it, and it's not very involved. It feels very passive. You can click on the community tab and see some stuff get pulled that way, but it's just not really in your face. The dark text and the dark backgrounds as well on Steam just kind of makes things feel, I don't know. Take some time to kind of view those components yourself on both platforms, and you'll see what I mean and be able to determine your own opinion on that aspect. Overall, I feel like there's major reasons to pick one over the other. For me, Steam has been around kind of, and it's just the dark and direct corporate world, in my opinion, while Discord's kind of popped up to be a flighty, brighty, and colorful company. In fact, if you read any of their blogs, they're all like the cool, hip dad versus the angry grandpa that Valve's always been. For that, I think the tone personally in Discord makes it viable regardless of the mistakes that they've made kind of along the way, and it's about time someone really has stepped up to the plate. Steam is one of the best options partly due to being one of the earliest options, but it was only a matter of time before someone pops up. So I'm rooting for Discord to take number two spot at bare minimum and make light for developers to have options. Steam has already been pushing actually for more chat and community options on their platform to try to compete with Discord, but realistically, it might be too late unless they really wow us with something that we haven't seen. With that, I wish Discord good luck, and Steam, I say to you, it's about time. For developers, at worst case, I think that this should at least cause Valve to make drastic changes to try to ensure they stay the top option and try to improve their platform for players as well. Do you think Discord will maintain the spotlight long enough to climb the ranks? Or maybe do you think Discord will become a viable platform for developers to release titles on, or will it just be a light option to consider? Let us know what you think about the new Discord store in the comments, and as always, we appreciate your feedback. Don't forget to subscribe for more game developer content and tutorials. Later, dudes.